Hey guys, what's up, and welcome to the vlog. Today we're going to be doing a cooking video for you guys. So, pretty simple recipe. What I got here is kettle corn. You can pretty much get this gravy in any store. It's called Hands Homemade Style Gravy Roasted Turkey. You can pretty much get it at any supermarket. Alright, so the first step, I got some stuff in here, so it's pretty good healthy loving today in MrRocker's house. But here's the ingredients you will need for this recipe. It's very simple. All you need is pepper. And if you have adobo, this is what I used. And so I did this and pepper. Just a little bit, not a whole lot, just a little pinch. To give it a little good taste. Right now it's still cooking, so this is the ingredients you're gonna need, basically. This gravy, and what I got here is sliced breast boneless chicken. You could pretty much you can ask a local supermarket if they could do that for you. I'm pretty sure they will. Or you could get them pre-cut. A nice good I'll put a chocolate milk here. Yep, MrRocker is doing a little better on eating habits. So, we got this cooking, we got stuffing, we got this. Let's wait for that to cook, waiting for that to finish cook. And I can't wait to show the finished product to you guys. It's gonna be amazing. Oh man, that smells awesome. Probably best thing I ever made. And what else I also had to wait to a vegetable is I added kettle corn. You have one kettle can of that. Let it cook it with all the flavors meant together. And you got a finished meal, baby. That smells amazing, guys. It smells like a turkey dinner, no joke. So that's a pretty simple recipe. If you guys want to see me do more of this, let me know in the comments below. I'd be happy to do some more for you guys. I love doing this for you guys, actually. Oh man. Oh, look at that, guys. That's like, oh man. That looks so awesome. Look at that. Oh yeah. Just a little pepper, guys. You put a little adobo at the beginning. And what I do to keep the chicken moist is I add water to it and I cover it. And guys, just make sure that your meat is at 165 degrees. That's a known fact. And let's make sure it's at 165 degrees. And if it looks like this, you're in good shape. You're in very good shape, actually. So I'm just letting this simmer, let all the flavors mend together so they could be married and happy. I don't know if you guys saw that. Sorry about that. But here's the so I got a little bit of this. Let that cook up, and woohoo! Pretty simple meal. It's cheap meal. You can make it at home. Again, I'll post the ingredients in the description below today's vlog. I hope you guys are having an amazing Holy Week, because this week is Holy Week. Kind of funny story. I want to share with you guys. I went to work today. I worked 2 hours. Did basically nothing. Because I texted the employee because I noticed nobody was coming in. I'm like, oh, okay. So I texted him. He's like, oh, see, it's an Easter holiday. I said, oh, okay. I didn't know. So I'll post the recipe in the description below today's vlog. Oh, man, guys. This smells so amazing. I got stuffing. That's just basic box stuffing. You know, it's basically what I have here. You got Kraft, it's just, you know, 1/4 cup of water and 1/4 of a teaspoon of butter. Pretty simple. There you go. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. I love every single one of you, including the haters. And if you guys want me to do more cooking book videos, let me know in the comments below as well. I'll post the recipe that I just did here in the description below. So let me give it a little more detail. So first, you cook your boneless chicken. Get the heat up the temperature, whatever. I usually keep it around medium heat. Medium heat, when you're cooking meat, so you want it to burn. Then you add the adobo and a little bit of pepper on it. You let that cook. You cover it for like 7 or 8 minutes. Then, actually no, 6 or 7. You don't need that long. Until there's no pink in the meat anymore. That's how you can tell it's done. Pretty simple recipe, but anyway, back to it. You got 1 can of this. You don't have to use the whole thing, guys. Just enough to cover the meat and whatever. Just use about maybe half of that. Not a whole lot. Sorry for the lighting. I know it's actually a lot better. I gotta say, the lighting's a lot better in here today. Don't really need salt. Don't forget that. Don't use that. Because the adobo has a salt seasoning in it already. Pretty much has all the seasoning you need for the meat anyhow. So just a teeny pinch of pepper, maybe like just a couple of shakes, and you're done. And then, once that's cooked, you add it all together. You add the kettle corn. And after that, well, it's your choice. If you want it watery, if you like it thick, if you're that person that likes thick gravy, that's entirely up to you. But what I did was I added just a little bit of water for the consistency. And as you can see, guys, we're pretty much done here. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to shut this off. That's already done. I already pre-made that earlier. That's pretty much done. Well, yeah, it's a pretty simple recipe. I'll put it in the description below so you guys can try it yourselves. It's very good. You can pretty much use any corn for this. Doesn't really matter. It could be kettle corn, regular corn, whatever your taste buds feel. That's what you do. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little cooking. Well, actually, no. I gotta plate this and give you guys the finished product. Alright, here we go. Yeah, I was contemplating if I was gonna do the vlog today, but you know what? I wanted to. Alright, so we're gonna put a little bit. Oh, and if you want a side dish, stupid cheese. If you want a little side dish, cranberry juice sauce is awesome. It's a very good. It just mixes very well with the meat and all the gravy and stuff. It's so good. And well, I'm gonna plate this up and it's a little bit of stuffing. Oh yeah, yeah, buddy. And a whole lot. Just enough. Gotta do this. I don't know. I'm pretty tidy when it comes to stuff like this. I don't know if you guys don't care, but now I'm gonna do this. Put some of that in here. And guys, this is a pretty healthy meal. I mean, not really. I didn't add any fat content in this. It's pretty low carb. Pretty healthy for you. Man, look at that, guys. We got a finished product. I just figured I'd do a little bit to give you guys a little taste of what it tastes like. And at first, hold on, I gotta see if I can get this open. Just open for you guys. It's gonna be a little tough. So just bear with me. So I'm trying to get the cranberry sauce open so I can have a little bit of that. Hope you guys are enjoying this cooking video. Remember, if you guys want me to do more of like step-by-step videos, let me know in the comments below. Alright, let's see if I can stand this up somewhere without it killing. Alright. Oh shit. Okay, alright. I managed to get it standing straight up. All right, so now, what I'm doing now is I'm opening the can of cranberry sauce. Guys, cranberry sauce is very good for your urinary tract areas. I highly recommend you guys eat this. It's very good for your colon. It's very good for pretty much, you know. So I just figured I'd put you guys there for a second. I'm just going to throw this away. And remember, guys, clean as you go. And that's pretty much what I'm doing here. And my dad always told me, clean as you go. That way you don't have to do anything at the end. You know what I mean? So what I'm doing now is just trying to get the thing out of there. The cranberry sauce, sorry. Yeah, I'm a little tired today, sorry. I can't believe it's staying. That's cool. We're just going to put this on a plate. You can put this on a small plate, or if you have a dish, that works for a very decadent piece. You can also put it in there, but fortunately, I only have a small plate, so that's not a thing for me. You just gotta really, here we go. Sometimes it cooperates, sometimes it doesn't. It's just what it is. Oh, getting old, man. Yeah, I do not like, there you go, guys. Put this in here. All right. Now, what I usually do is, I cut them into slices like this. I don't know if that's how you guys do it at home. The cranberry sauce I'm using is Ocean Spray. I don't know if you guys saw it. And look at that, it just fans out very nicely. You got a nice, awesome, healthy meal here, guys. All right, we're gonna put about a half one on there. And here's the final product, guys. I don't know if you can see this, hold on. Here's the final product. Doesn't that look good, guys? Now, it's a pretty simple recipe to make. Very simple. Now, to taste it. Yeah. My favorite part. Yeah, buddy. All right. Hold on. I just got to make sure everything's tight. Okay. All right. Now, just going to get a little bit of everything. A little bit of this, a little bit of stuff in here. I'm gonna try that. Oh my god. Very easy meal to make, guys. Oh my god. Chicken is so moist. Oh. That's good. Very good. So, I hope you enjoyed today's cooking video. I hate this phone. I hope you guys enjoyed this cooking video. Oh man, is that good. I'll put that recipe in the description below so you guys can try it out. Thank you so much for watching. Remember, you guys are unique, you're awesome, you're beautiful, and don't let anybody tell you different. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys! Woo! Until next time.